Hi, this is Sean Overton. Right now you're in the support area of One Step Removed. This area exists to help document and give us a schedule for testing. It's important that you learn how to use it because it facilitates communication between you, me, and the programmer. It helps us keep track of what technical issues may exist in the programming and what's currently being done to fix it. So let's get started.
Now that you've received the email telling you where to find your file to download, this is the first thing you'll see when you come on the page. You'll be prompted to log into the forum. After you've logged in, this is what comes up. It'll have the project number followed by user acceptance testing, then a message like you see in this video, and your video is right below it. Off to the right, you'll see a box that says Issue Details, and this has all the information for updating the status. If you click on the word requested next to status, you'll notice that you're able to change it. Most importantly, at the bottom, you'll see the assigned users. Currently in this image, it's Sean Overton and Wade McPherson. When you click on either the names or the arrow right next to the assigned users, you'll see this type of box come up. The left side is the people that are not currently assigned, and on the right, that represents the people that are currently assigned. So if I wanted to unassign Wade, I would send him into the left box, and if I wanted to add him again, I would take him from the left box and put him in the right box. Next, if you want to download your file, you'll see it all the way at the bottom of the page. So scroll to the very bottom, you'll see the attachments followed by the project number, .mq4. That's the file that you'll load into MetaTrader. To make sure you put it in the right place, you put it in Experts, in Program Files, the name of your broker, and Experts. If you want to upload a log file, this is what you absolutely need to do anytime you report a problem. We almost always need the log file, and it will speed up the process if you upload it without us asking. To find the log file, you go to C:, Program Files, your broker name, Experts, and Logs. Then the file we need is based on the date you had the problem. So if you had a problem on the 19th of October 2009, you would look for a file called 2009, 10 for the month, and 19 for the day. Push open. Now you'll see the ability to push upload. So push the upload button and you're done. If you have a problem and you want to actually explain it in text, that's where you use the quick reply feature. Quick reply, you just type it and literally just push post reply and you're done. Now let's say that you decide that the user acceptance testing thread is getting a little long and you decide you want to post a new bug report. The way you do that is you scroll to the top. You can see where it's got home, MetaTrader, so it's up in near the menu bar. Click on your project title. Once you do that, you'll be taken to a new page. It's mostly blank, but you'll see on the left there it's got the post new issue. So if you click on post new issue and bug, that'll take you to a new page where you can fill out information like before, but this way it starts a new thread and helps keep the information in a shorter format. One very important item is that you need to assign users if you want us to know about it. So if you post a new bug but you don't tell Sean Overton and your programmer that this issue exists, we'll never get an email that this was posted. So it's very important that when you post one of these, you always assign a programmer. If you have any questions, give me a call. My number is 866-212-1544. And again, this is Sean Overton with One Step Removed.